The new digital platform known as the World Wide Web has given voice to a generation of previously unheard artists and creators. Using computer processing and with major software developments, radical changes have taken place from the 60s and continue to develop. In this section, we're going to look at how the internet has allowed cross-pollination, publication, and helped the audiovisual scene expand to its present state. The history of digital art has been influenced as much by the history of science and technology as by the historical and artistic influences. The employment of technologies as an artistic medium has drawn influence from the historical art movements such as op art, dadaism, constructivism, minimalism, conceptual art, kinetic art, and fluxus, which all focused on instructions, concept, and event participation happening. In the 1960s, performance, conceptual, and digital art emerged in parallel to the evolution of new technologies. Using computer processing and with software developments, radical changes took place in the 60s and continue to develop in present times. According to Rosalie Goldberg, performance consolidated its presence in art from the beginning of the century, stating a large tradition of artists that will assume it as a preferent creative process and a media of expression. Around the ideas of reproduction and media art and communication, Nam June Paik pioneered streaming online audiovisual performances and anticipated that the internet would be used to produce network art, net art, hacktivism, and other artists of Fluxus movement developed these ideas and concepts through their language of art. The term cyberspace was used by Norbert Wiener in the decade of the 1940s for referring to the comparative study of different communication control systems, such as the computer and the human brain. Setting the beginnings for science and cybernetics, which his theories conformed the base for, his understanding of the so-called man and machine symbiosis concept later very much influenced digital artists. American writers such as Burroughs and Gibson used the term and believed in the potential of computers and computer networks for individual empowerment. Computer art emerged in the 1970s, and at that point it was referred to as multimedia art. When the internet was realized, cyberspace became a synonym especially used in academic circles. So the major transformation from analog and mechanical technologies to digital technologies had its standardization in the 1990s and continues to develop throughout our time. According to Marius Watts, a new media artist, curator, and teacher, code is the language of the digital world where algorithms articulate form as a function of process and where each image is just one of a possibility of an infinite number of results. The environment of digital data is fluid and always capable of change. Works developing the idea of data into form can take one of two roles, synthesis or mapping. Synthesis is creating form out of nothing from formal rules, shapes, grammars, and kinetic models. And mapping data structures are given form through transformation and interpretation. A clear example of synthesis of creativity and innovation in arts and philosophy of humanizing technology is John Maeder, a contemporary designer and artist of our times whose works and theories have exerted a strong influence in digital culture and the development of actual art. In his early works, he developed electronic media as a tool for expression, and in combination with computer programming and a sensitivity to artistical and educational concerns. Actual president of the Rhode Island School of Design, the artist for more than a decade worked on the issues of integration of technology in education and arts. Maeder studied for a long time, earning a bachelor's and master's in computer science and electrical engineering from MIT, where he met Muriel Cooper, the pioneer in design and electronic communication. He later finished a PhD in design science from the Scuba Institute of Art and Design in Japan, where he met Ikko Tanaka, and then collected an MBA from the Arizona State University, where he connected with the famous designer Paul Rand in America. Returning to work for more than a decade with the team members of the MIT Media Lab, during the 1990s, he created Design by Numbers, a programming environment and language for introducing artists and visual designers into computational design. The software ran on a browser and was free and easy to use. The first version of the software inspired Midas students like Casey Rees and Ben Fry, that went on to develop later the software known as processing. Scott Draves, also known as Spot, is a visual and software artist that, when the World Wide Web was new in 1993, he released the Flame algorithm as open source. As one of the earliest applications of GPL to art, Scott Draves received an honorary mention at the pre-R Electronica with one of the earliest fractal flames, number 149. Also known as the creator of the electric sheep, this open-source screensaver animated fractal flame designs and created new flames using driven algorithms. The community started to build on his code, connecting a worldwide community of designers and programmers, and developing the look and possibility of electric sheep and the flames. The electric sheep community is evolving continually, with over 350,000 participants in the development of an infinite abstract animation. The art critic Rachel Green states that the term net art originated when Slovakian artist Vuk Kosic opened an anonymous email only to find that it had been mangled in transmission. Amid a morass of alphanumeric gibberish, Kosic could make out only one legible term, net art, which he began to use and talk about online through his communications. The first curatorial project of a web-based net art work was by the Guggenheim Museum and was developed by Xu Li Xiang, presented in 1997. Norbert Pfaffenbichler refers to generative art when concerned with formalist abstraction and self-contained systems that could be considered software. Organizer of Generator X, a platform for generative art and computational design. The main topics of interest verse on computational aesthetics and generative systems as an artistic strategy. Related to actual artworks, the work of ubermorgan.com is essential in understanding the relationship between conceptual art and media hacking. Works like Vote Auction took place between the online and real happenings during the American presidential electoral process in the year 2000. And Deep Horizon. In 2010, a project of digital oil paintings connecting to one of the major ecological disasters of the Atlantic Sea. The curator Domenico Quaranta produced in 2010 the idea that new technologies, new media, and new ways of addressing vital questions, as well as how cultures have contextualized these technological changes, is constantly modifying, not only out of the way in which we live, but also the way in which we make art, and even the very notion of art itself. This means a true revolution in terms of cultural production, with a rise of technologies such as photography, film, and animation, underlining that some artists have embraced new media enthusiastically, while others are being forced to reconsider the way in which they work in conventional media like painting and sculpture. Yet others have done both things, and art has changed beyond all recognition in those cases.